All right, in this episode, I'm going to show you how I converted the incandescent meter lamps on this Studer A80 24-track reel-to-reel into LED meter lamps, so stay tuned. Okay, so I've already done the lower amps and all of this on the right channel, except for the top one. All these had the old lamp burnout in them. All 24 channels were burnout, but the old lamp was still there. So I'm going to show you, instead of buying a real expensive $5 or $6 LED replacement, you can just fix them with a standard LED and a resistor. So I've still got this many to do. This one, I had to put the brand new analog lamp in. And so this is gonna be the difference between what a new old stock Studer lamp is compared to the LED. Let me do a close up. Okay, so this is the original brand new old stock lamp. And here are the LED replacements. I used the umber color LED, so they're a little hotter on the center. They're not as evenly distributed, but that's all I could get. I couldn't find the replacement. There it is without the meter, so it's still better than nothing. So I've replaced all these down here with the LED replacements. And I hate to, but I'm gonna have to crush this bulb because I do not have any burnout lamps in stock at this moment to replace them with. All these hopefully still have the old bulb base in there, which we'll be using. Okay, so all you're going to need is a pack of LEDs. These are like just a standard LED. These are umber color. You can get bright white if you want, but I want to keep it authentic looking. And of course, this is a 24 volt lamp in here, so you can't just put the LED directly in the socket. You're going to need 15K resistors. I've got some big ones here. It did end up not having enough in stock, so I had to order some more smaller. It can be quarter watt like these. It's not drawing any current because it's going to be wired in series with this LED. So to get the old bulb out, I kind of just take my tweezers and turn it. You can take a screwdriver, turn it, and it falls right out. So after I get it out, I will bend this forward because they seem to get bent. Same with the little contactor in the center. Bend it as much as you can forward, so when you put the new bulb in, it'll make good contact. So I hate to do this. This is actually a working bulb. All the others were not working. So you just take and crush this lamp right here with a pair of pliers. Like so. And then take a screwdriver, a flat bladed screwdriver, it's a fairly small one, and just kind of carve out all this stuff in here. All you're using is this base. So you want to make sure you get that center conductor out of there. Sometimes that center conductor is a real fine piece of copper. It'll break and it'll make contact with the side. Just make sure it's not in there. On some occasions, that after you scrape it all out with a screwdriver, doesn't look like it. In this case, the wire is still connected. The wire will still be connected, so you just heat this up with a soldering iron and take a pair of pliers and pull that wire out from the inside. But it looks like this one, wire broke off clean. All right, so anyway, what I do is I cut off that about an eighth inch long. I will take the resistor and do the same. I'll cut off about an eighth of an inch, stick it out, straighten everything out, then I'll take the soldering iron and solder that resistor right to the center. On, you have to hold this. I am getting too old. It's hard to believe I put ribbons in microphones, but I'm getting too old to stop shaking. Solder that on. Make sure it's got a good mechanical connection. And then I just cut a little piece of heat shrink tubing, big enough to fit over the center conductor right here. I'll go ahead and shrink that on. Like that. This saves me not only money, but time. They didn't have enough LEDs in stock. So all you gotta do is trim this back about a quarter inch. And then you'll bend this up, put a nice, lost my pliers. Put a nice crook about like that and give that some solder. So when you put it in the thing, put it in the base, it will attach. So I tin it, some solder, just a little bit. It's actually too much, but that's good. Now, where'd that base go? Okay. So now it's just simply heat this dab of solder here in the center up, and I'll show you a simple way of doing that. Okay, I just push down. I just hold it like, I gotta do this, hard to do this while on camera. So I just push down on it while heating this up, and it pokes through and comes right up the center. So you see what I'm doing here is basically making an LED in the old socket. So I push this on the inside, so it looks something like that. Then I will solder it here. And this saves a lot of time and money. I will put it. Actually, what I do is I'll solder the this on first. That will hold it this direction, and then I can solder the ground on. Focusing most of the heat on the base, and then I can simply, once it cools down, cut it right here. But you're not done yet. Ow, it's still too hot. There it is. An LED, it doesn't matter how it looks because it's all enclosed inside of the meter lamp assembly, which is not really seen by the human eye. So you take a file and just file the top down so it's a flat spot. And you file down the end so it's got a nice set of tweezers, and I'll line up those little tabs here so they go . It's really hard doing this on camera, and you just basically slide it in here, push it with my hand while turning it here, and once you turn it, it locks it in, and there's enough tension here since I bent the spring back. And there's how it looks once installed, and it's far enough away it doesn't put too hot of a spot in here. So there it is. That's saves a lot of money. Instead of paying $5 a piece for lamps, now you can do it for whatever a pack of these cost and a pack of 15K resistors. And so we just slide it back in position, and it should be good to go. Four screws that come out, obviously long ones here, short ones here. Turn it on, and there we go. We got our LED meters.
And there it is, got the meters. There's, like I say, it's a little hot spot in the middle, but not bad. I can turn some of the lights off here. And that's in a fully lit room. See the difference? Meter lamps, no meter lamps.
All right, got all the meter lights working. This thing's a work of art. Watch how stable all these meters are. 10 kilohertz now.
all the meter lights working. This thing is rock solid. Every single amp got her all tuned up.
16 kilohertz.
Yep, see what I mean? 16. I could tweak it a little bit. I've seen a couple that are low. Could just be the heads are dirty. But pretty impressive. All 24 tracks that flat. Gonna hook up the auto locator next and align the record section. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button, and I'll see you on the next episode. Locate. And there's a location.
Royal calibration tape at 250 nanowatts.